Hello there, and the story ninjas in the house. Well, listening ninjas, a little bit more about Thoko. Thoko was created by Niki, Daly. So he wrote the stories and illustrated the pictures. So our pictures in this book are all black and white sketches, but with your imagination, I know that you are able to add plenty and plenty of colour. Well, let's find out what our Thoko gets up to in this story. It's called Thoko's Reward. Well, Thoko, Mama and Gogo often went out for a walk. And whenever they were out, Mama looked up at the sky and she said, "Oh my, what beautiful clouds in the blue sky." Gogo would look all around her and say things like, "Oh, that's a beautiful tree. And that lady's wearing a nice dress." You know, stuff like that. And Thoko liked looking, yes, down at the ground. Because things grew there, like flowers. There were cracks in pavements that she could jump over. And that is where she found it. What's it, you may be saying? She found a ring in the crack in the pavement. And it wasn't one of those play rings that you buy in surprise packets. It wasn't a cheap ring that Mama could afford to buy at the market. This was a real ring. Sparkling diamond in gold. Oh my gosh! There was one big one in the middle and two little ones on either side. Sparkly stones, possibly diamonds, eh? "Look what I found, Mama," said Thoko. And Mama took the ring out of Toko's hand and had a good look. "Well, this looks like a very special ring," she said. And Mama slipped it onto one of her fingers. And it fitted absolutely perfectly. Gogo leaned over and said, "Find us keepers." "Can we keep it?" asked Thoko. "Do you think it's right if they keep it?" "Let's find out what they did." No, said Mama. "This looks like an engagement ring. We must find the person who lost it and give it back. The lady who lost this must be very, very sad because it obviously would have been something special to her." "Oh, now she won't be able to get married," thought Thoko. No, it's not as bad as that," said Mama. "But it's very sad to lose something this precious." And when they returned home, Gogo made tea and they sat down to discuss what to do with this ring. And they decided to put an ad in the newspaper to ask if anyone had lost the ring along the main road. Well, now they were having a discussion. Ads cost too much. Thoko said you could make a poster. You know, Thoko loves to paint and draw. "Well, that's a super idea, Thoko. You make such beautiful pictures," said Mama. "And, you can add my number. My cell phone number to the poster," said Mama. Thoko thought, "I can draw a picture of a ring." Mama said, and Gogo also adds in, "Bad idea. The person who calls must tell us what it looks like, and then we can hand it over. So only the real owner will know what it looks like. Is that right?" "Agreed, yes." "Yes, that's true," said Mama. "But I'm sure Thoko will make a beautiful poster anyway. See, it's always good to have discussions about things. You agree?" Everyone puts in their ideas, and somehow we will all come up with one good idea. While Thoko was starting to feel a bit excited about making this poster that would help the lady find her lost ring. And Thoko got out of her drawing pad, her felt tips, her glitter, her paints, and she began making a poster. And in very big letters she wrote, "Ring found," and in smaller figures, Mama's telephone number. Then she made a flower border using all her brightest colours. Now I know plenty of you get to make posters for school. Or sometimes you just love to make posters, just to say something special. Well, anyway, the poster was now done. It really did look special and sparkly. She added some extra blobs of glue onto the flowers around the border. Well, Gogo says, it is a fabulous poster. Let's go and put it up where we found the ring. And there outside the art center was a pole, just the right size to tie Thoko's poster. Let's have a good look again. It was lovely and big and clear enough for everyone to see the message. Coco says, well, now we need to wait. Well. No sooner had the poster been up and they were at home, Mama's cell phone rang. Hello, I'm calling about the ring, said a gruff voice. I see, said Mama. Will you please tell me what your ring looks like?
It's big, said the man. Well, not that big, but it has a big diamond in it.
And Mama could tell that the man was making it all up. Mama's good like that, you know. So she said, I'm so sorry, but we did not find your ring. And that was that. You know, Mama means serious business.
Hush, said Mama.
There's so many chances out there. And Gogo says, it sounds as though you are taking a real big chance. And during the week, two more chances tried their luck. And one said the ring was silver, and the other said the ring had a moonstone heart. Do you think Mama fell for that? No, I think Mama's too smart. And then Thoko started feeling disappointed. The last time she saw a poster on the pole, it looked a bit torn up and beaten about by the weather. Oh, perhaps they'll never find the lady who that ring belonged to. Oh, how sad. And then one morning, a young woman called and described her lost ring. It's my engagement ring, she said, and it has three diamonds on a gold band. That's right, said Mama. You may come and collect your ring. And when Mama shared the news with Thoko, you can imagine Thoko was quite excited. Oh, could we have a special tea to celebrate? Gogo agreed. Yes, definitely. After all those chances, let's celebrate people who are honest. And what a lovely celebration it was. And here the young lady had come to fetch her ring. Oh, man, this is a special time. I'll never take my ring off again, said Belinda, was the young lady who had lost her ring. I teach art at the art center, and on Saturday mornings, I don't want to damage my ring, you know, with the paint and clay and things. So I took my ring off and put it in my pocket, and it must have fallen out when I took my keys out. Well, Belinda told him all about her boyfriend. They call them a fiancé when they are just engaged. And this was the man she was going to marry. And guess what? Belinda invited them all to a wedding. That was not all she said. When she learned that Thoko had made the beautiful poster, she said, Thoko, for being such an honest girl, let's have a look. I'm sure you can start guessing what was next. I'd like to reward you by inviting you to join my art class every Saturday morning for no charge. My goodness, Thoko loved it. Imagine being invited to an art class every Saturday. Well, just look at Toko's beautiful picture of Belinda and Sam's wedding. See, Mama. Mama looks up at the sky. Gogo looks all around her at pretty dresses and things. And there's Thoko. Let's have a look again. Looking down at the ground. Finding little treasures. And what is she seeing at the wedding? Thoko looking down at the ground. It's covered in confetti, glittering like diamonds in the sun. Well, I'm sure this is going to inspire you to be looking all about. Okay, be careful of what you find. Right, until next time, goodbye.